Malera Tholi Maliko is a widow and AIDS patient. She supports 8 children, 4 of her own and 4 from a niece who died of AIDS this year. For her, like millions of others in remote areas of this vast continent, traveling to the clinic to pick up her pills is half the battle. Every trip begins with a long walk through rocky pastures. Maliko is weak because most days her family eats only papa, cornmeal mush. And for Maliko, bus fare is $3.25, more than the daily wage for her work washing clothes.
My problem is transport. Next tomorrow, I will go in to see a doctor, but I haven't go because I have no money for transport. Big problem. Of course, if I know I have no pills, I'm going to heaven.
Global Fund grants, including hundreds of millions of dollars from the Gates Foundation, rarely provide enough food along with AIDS medicine. Dozens of the patients described hunger so severe that they vomited their pills.
So the situation is terrible here. It's very terrible. We are not getting what we are supposed to get. We as patients of HIV, you know.
People with HIV must not starve here. We are dying because of starvation. Yes.
Partners in Health, or PIH, and other NGOs try to fill the gaps. PIH patients and their families receive food for up to 10 months. Some government officials fear that free food promotes a cycle of poverty and dependence, but people working with AIDS patients praise PIH's efforts. They say that the fight against AIDS in sub-Saharan Africa can't be won unless it includes a war on hunger.
How many children are you responsible for today?
28.
And how many nurses are in this care unit?
I'm alone.
Short on staff and equipment, Queen 2 is typical of the level of medical care in much of sub-Saharan Africa. Grantees of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation support testing and treatment for AIDS and TB at Queen 2, but nothing for the nursery. Nurse Moda is monitoring 6 newborns who are having respiratory problems.
When their breathing is fast, we have to put them on oxygen to correct that problem.
A makeshift system of rubber tubing connects all 6 babies to a single oxygen tank.
They're sharing. We do not have enough.
That is that.
In another room, Matsepeng Nioba has just given birth to Mankwebe, a baby girl. Limp and barely breathing, the newborn is clearly in trouble. Nurse Lilo Kwape uses a foot pump in an attempt to clear the baby's lungs. Then he tries to hook her up to an oxygen tank, but the valve isn't working. He rushes over to the nursery, but there's no room for a 7th baby on his jury-rigged oxygen system. Her weak lungs soon failed, and she died. Two days later, a neighbor shaves Matsepeng's head in a mourning ritual. A $35 valve could have saved the baby and many more who die the same way, but it's not covered by the grants pouring into Lesotho from the Gates Foundation or others. The money buys expensive medicine that will help Matsepeng in her battle against the AIDS virus, but among the millions of people saved from AIDS, many die from other ailments. A raft of problems offset many benefits of the assistance and expose doubts about how the aid is used.
I'm
In Lesotho, some AIDS sufferers claim to have been bewitched rather than risk the stigma of infection. To ease that stigma, patients at this rural clinic sing with pride about their HIV status, which they literally wear on their chests. Joseph, himself an AIDS patient, is showing the class how to use condoms. He has been treated and trained by Doctors Without Borders, a non-governmental organization that works in sub-Saharan Africa. Joseph and other lay health workers are compensating for a shortage of professional clinicians. Patients here often die from a lack of basic supplies or from poor sanitation in clinics or hospitals. In the mountain village of Nohana, Dr. Jennifer Furin of the NGO Partners in Health is preparing to do a spinal tap.
Right there, I just need to pop through, and if you had just like another eighth of an inch, you would.
High-quality, comprehensive care, such as that provided by PIH at clinics that operates with the government, is rare in much of Africa. The children of Samong Kong are getting measles vaccinations. For many villagers in remote areas, vaccine drives can be a rare chance to see a doctor or nurse. These mothers all had stories of hunger, TB, or AIDS. But today it's just measles vaccinations, vitamin A, and deworming medicine. The vaccination coordinators and funders, including UNICEF, supported by the Gates Foundation, forbade any other health screening that day. The Gates Foundation has provided billions of dollars to support care in Africa, saving many lives. But Partners in Health and other experts said the support could have been dramatically more effective if it was more focused on improving overall health services and clinical staffing instead of restricted to a few diseases. They urge the foundation to attack a root cause of ill health in Africa, poverty.